Today, begin praying in Hebrew without any study, without any background, in under 5 minutes. How this powerful principle of confessing the Word of God can bear fruit in your life on Jewish Voice.
Shalom and welcome to Jewish Voice, a program to help you to understand the Jewish roots of your Christian faith, Bible prophecy, and world events surrounding Israel. You know, I've served in ministry now for more than 30 years, and I have witnessed the power of confessing the Word of God. I've seen people healed, delivered, and literally transformed through confessing and hearing the Word of God. We're told in Romans 10:9 that faith comes through hearing, and hearing the Word of God, and it works in every language. But the Word, or at least the Old Testament, was written in the original Hebrew language. Now, I believe in the power of confession, biblical confession, but I also believe in the significance of Hebrew and how it works. But first, I want to introduce you to a good friend of mine. He's been here many times. We call him our resident Hebrew scholar. He is a native Hebrew speaker, a Sabra, and he's here today to help us appreciate the power of the Hebrew language. It will unlock keys that will bring revelation into your life. Please welcome my good friend, Dr. Danny Ben Gigi. Danny, always good to have you, Danny.
Thank you.
Welcome back. Thanks. Well, we share in common many things. We have the same barber.
Hairstyle, yes, right.
And I like to say that God knows every need. He has every hair on our head numbered. And in our case, it's a little easier for
much
him.
Easier. But, Archibald, Lisa, and John.
But Danny, we also share in common a love for the Hebrew language.
Yes.
And you're far further along than I am. I diligently studied in Hebrew school as a child, but conversational Hebrew, I'm still really stuck. And so we rely on you Hebrew when we use Hebrew in our magazine and in different resources. I want you to be just introduce the topic again of why Christians watching should consider Hebrew or understanding Hebrew.
Okay.
Why?
For me, it's very easy to explain that. I start talking Hebrew in the moment I was born, or maybe a few minutes later. The language gets you much closer to the source. If you look at Hebrew, it's a very systematic, it has almost a hidden, mysterious DNA formula in every single Hebrew word. What does it mean? Basically, every word has a root. Every Hebrew word has a root that it's almost like a nucleus DNA that many other words build around it. That means that the Hebrew language is very concise in its spectrum. Very few words, comparing to English, maybe one-tenth of what you have in English, but yet very, very sharp and deep language. Take, for instance, a nucleus word, like take the word, for instance, of Adam, man. Okay, what does the word Adam, which is a key word in the Bible, God creates Adam, man, mankind, what that has to do with blood, what that has to do with ground, what that has to do with tears, and other words that English has no indication of any connection whatsoever.
So when it says that God formed man out of the dust or the earth,
he does say it
is what it is, but in Hebrew there's much more.
But a lot of people, when they read it in English, they say, all right, here's a story, you have a narrative. It tells you that man is made out of dust. Where is the proof? You see, a lot of people will doubt that because they don't get an intrinsic, a built-in proof. Hebrew provides it, but the nature of that nucleus. Take the word Adam, and now look at the word earth in Hebrew. Almost the same word, Adama. You hear the connection? Adam, Adama. And if you say, well, it's a coincidence, this connection. But many people, even Christian, good believers, you know, they are bombarded day and night by scientific so-called evidence of truth. And they will start doubting because of so much bombardment of science. There are doubts and biblical stories. But the Hebrew is put you back. It almost put you in handcuffs. By looking at the words there, you cannot argue with them.
In other words, I think what I'm hearing you say is there's a divine design.
Exactly.
In Hebrew, for example, the connection of man and dust,
I could
dirt,
not, more than that,
is,
Jonathan.
Is the same word, is a derivative of the
more
same word.
More than that, Jonathan. If you just say those two, people say, well, it's a coincidence that Adam, man, is very close to the word Adama, soil or ground. But go further. Look what runs in our veins. Blood, right? The word blood, listen to the sound. Dam. You heard it? Adam, Adama, Dam. That's blood.
Are you all seeing the connection? So the life of the flesh, the life of man is in the blood.
Exactly.
And it's connected to the same word as man, which is connected to the ground.
Exactly. So there are many perspectives that it is shining through, literally shining through. And you don't really need to learn much. I mean, you wrote it in your book too. But the next one in the step, and I want really every Christian to feel very comfortable to get into that. Put one step forward and you confess something that you've never done in your life. Jonathan, the next word on that list is the color red. What red has to do with ground, with men?
I know the answer.
You know the answer. I know. This one is, of course, Adam, right? Listen, Adam, Adama, and then the word dam, which is blood, and then the word of the color, always connected to one another, Adam. And so is the next word, Edom. Why Edom? This nation, or those fierce nation, is called Edom. What's the reason for that? You know the answer, right? The two brothers, right? Jacob is making him a dish that is red, and he's about to give it to him, and he
red
calls
lentils,
him,
ladies and gentlemen.
Right, and he calls him, because of this red, I'll call you Edom. So the Edomites that appear so many times in the Bible, 102 times in the Bible, got their name because of the color red that relates to blood, which is in the story of creation, that relates to ground, and that relates to Adam.
I believe that Hebrew unlocks keys of revelation.
Absolutely.
And I want to look at more examples, but I know what everybody's thinking right now. They're thinking, okay, well, that's great, and that's a great example, but Hebrew, I'm 55 years old. I'm 60 years old. I'm not going to go learn Hebrew. I'm not going to go take a Hebrew course, but it's not that hard.
Number one, it's not their heart. Number two, not every person needs to learn the Hebrew.
We got to take a break. We're going to explain how really easy it is. We're going to show you just how really easy it is to dig into Hebrew, to confess scriptures in their original Hebrew. Anyone can do it starting now, even you. And then later in the show, a very important update on some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Don't go away.
Your gracious gift and support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinics to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Zimbabwe, who clearly have ties to the ancient people of Israel, particularly the Levites, and have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams will provide more than just physical care and comfort. They will share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their promised Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital upcoming outreach. Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. You can help save them, but you must act now. Will you be a blessing to these needy Jewish people? Call or click right now to share life-saving help, and we'll send you a very special set of gifts as an expression of our thanks. Share a gift of support of any amount for these outreaches today. And we'll say thank you by rushing you your personal copy of the resource discussed on today's broadcast, the new provision edition of Confessing the Hebrew Scriptures. This brand new hardcover guidebook and companion audio CD will lead you step by step into proclaiming in the original Hebrew language God's wonderful promises concerning provision. Discover the life-changing power of proclaiming God's provision promises in Hebrew. And you don't need to know Hebrew to get this book. Just begin to work through the pages using the simple transliteration method it describes, and you will be confessing the Hebrew scriptures in no time. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more today, we'll also send you a replica of one of the Dead Sea Scrolls and the jar they were stored in when discovered by a shepherd boy in the desert at Qumran. One of the most important archaeological finds of our faith, these scrolls, mostly written in Hebrew, confirm that the Bible was translated with meticulous accuracy over the centuries, while giving insight into the Jewish roots of our faith, both before and during Jesus' lifetime. Plus, you'll also receive a companion poster that delves even deeper into the story behind the miraculous preservation of these scrolls. Both of these gifts will serve as inspirational reminders that God watches over His inspired word to and for us. Finally, as an ongoing expression of our thanks for choosing to help so many in need, you'll also receive our illuminating and inspiring magazine, Jewish Voice Today. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share an urgently needed gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Please act now. Today, begin praying in Hebrew without any study, without any background, in under 5 minutes. How this powerful principle of confessing the Word of God can bear fruit in your life on Jewish Voice.
Welcome back. Let's get into confessing, because I believe in the power of confessing. I think confession has been given a bum rap, yes, because of all of the false teaching. But the confession of the Word of God, the speaking forth,
yes,
of the Word of God really brings life to the Word. And you've helped me produce a product, several products, that make the Christian that has no knowledge of Hebrew to actually begin to speak in Hebrew almost immediately.
Yes.
Immediately.
Yes.
Let's show it on the screen and explain to us how this works, Danny.
You read basically English characters and you're emanating Hebrew words. Simple as it is, and you can see the little accent marks that tell you where to put the emphasis, right?
So you have the English scripture that ties into a name of God.
Yes.
So which reveals the character, the very nature of God.
Exactly.
And then you have the Hebrew, the actual Hebrew characters.
Right.
And then you have the transliteration below it.
That allows people to confess instantaneously the Hebrew scripture in the tongue, in the holy, mysterious, I would say, tongue of God, bringing them, each one of you, much more closer to the word.
Now, Danny, I know people are looking at the screen and saying, I see it in English, but I don't know if I can pronounce it.
They need to look at the vowels there.
Here's how it's so easy. We have a CD where we have a native Hebrew speaker actually speaking it out, and you follow along with it, and boom, that easy.
Slowly.
I think we actually have an audio clip that we're going to play. Okay, so here's how it works.
Chapter 26, verses 3 and 4. If you walk in my statutes, keep my mitzvot, and carry them out, then I will give you rains in their season. The land will yield its crops, and the trees of the field will yield their fruit. Leviticus 26, verses 3 and 4.
אם בחוקותיי תלכו ואת מצוותיי תשמרו ועשיתם אותם ונתתי גשמכם בעיתם ונתנה הארץ יבולה ועץ השדה ייתן פריו.
Well done.
Thank you, thank you. And then to read that, Jonathan, if somebody wants to say it, small increments.
Beautiful Hebrew, Dan.
Thank you.
My gosh.
Well, you don't conquer the whole world in one.
But the beauty of this is that you can follow along, and when you finally have the courage by yourself, you can actually begin to recite it along with you.
Yes.
Or an earlier one's our dear friend Amnon Shore. And you're speaking Hebrew. You're confessing a promise of God. You see what it says in English, but you actually learn to pronounce it perfectly.
Right in the beginning, in a slow
perfectly.
Pace.
In the holy tongue, right? In the holy tongue.
Yes.
Praying in the Hebrew tongue.
Right.
Now, Danny, you always say praying in the holy tongue in Hebrew is preferable. God answers every language.
Every
but there's
language.
Something about speaking in Hebrew that has power.
Yes.
Can you unpack that? We just have a couple minutes
left. I can't, but this is what the sages were telling us from the dawn of history. Pray in Hebrew, pray in the tongue. They probably knew something that I really don't know the reason. Some, there are theories, Jonathan. Some say that Hebrew vibrates differently in the universe. This is his book, this is his language.
When I heard God spoke the world into existence using the Hebrew
language.
And there's a creative force in the Hebrew.
Well, that's what they're saying.
True or not true, you have to decide for yourself. One thing we can all agree on is that confession of God's word, specifically relating to a need, grabbing hold of a promise to meet that need, changes things. And once it gets into your heart, we confess with our mouth.
Exactly.
And we believe in our heart. And when we hear it enough, it gets into our heart, faith is released. And I sure love doing it in Hebrew.
Furthermore, the sages said in the same explanation that it's preferred, and they rather have people praying in Hebrew. They said that it's preferable to say the prayer, even a short one, in Hebrew, even if the praying person does not understand the words to that extent.
Well, that speaks to me growing up. I learned to read Hebrew.
But you did something right.
You know, the typical bar mitzvah boy, right?
Right.
I'm speaking in Hebrew, and I only know that text.
Well, you reached pretty far, didn't you? And the way is still up in front of you, right?
It's all relative, Danny. I'm sitting
it
next
is.
To you feeling small.
Well.
When it comes to Hebrew. But there's so much revelation, and Hebrew is a key that unlocks mysteries. And we see a divine order, we see a divine connection. And if you'd like to experience all of the blessings that God has in store for you, you can raise your hand at home. I really want to encourage you to get Confessing the Hebrew Scriptures. The Lord will provide. This one is specifically focused on the revelation, the nature of God that He provides for every need according to His riches and glory in the Messiah. Lots more ahead, but first, here's an important message about some very needy Jewish people.
Your gracious gift in support of the work of Jewish Voice right now will make you a vital part of providing life-saving medical help to some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. Today, we are urgently preparing for our next medical clinics to bless a remote Lost Tribes community in Zimbabwe, who clearly have ties to the ancient people of Israel, particularly the Levites, and have been practicing distinctly Jewish customs for centuries. Our medical teams will provide more than just physical care and comfort. They will share God's love and the good news that Jesus is their promised Messiah. Today, we urgently need your help to equip and fund this vital upcoming outreach. Time is literally running out for many of the most vulnerable there, especially infants and toddlers. You can help save them, but you must act now. Will you be a blessing to these needy Jewish people? Call or click right now to share life-saving help, and we'll send you a very special set of gifts as an expression of our thanks. Share a gift of support of any amount for these outreaches today. And we'll say thank you by rushing you your personal copy of the resource discussed on today's broadcast. The new provision edition of Confessing the Hebrew Scriptures. This brand new hardcover guidebook and companion audio CD will lead you step by step into proclaiming in the original Hebrew language God's wonderful promises concerning provision. Discover the life-changing power of proclaiming God's provision promises in Hebrew. And you don't need to know Hebrew to get this book. Just begin to work through the pages using the simple transliteration method it describes, and you will be confessing the Hebrew Scriptures in no time. And if God has blessed you with the means to share a gift of $100 or more today, we'll also send you a replica of one of the Dead Sea Scrolls and the jar they were stored in when discovered by a shepherd boy in the desert at Qumran. One of the most important archaeological finds of our faith, these scrolls, mostly written in Hebrew, confirm that the Bible was translated with meticulous accuracy over the centuries, while giving insight into the Jewish roots of our faith, both before and during Jesus' lifetime. Plus, you'll also receive a companion poster that delves even deeper into the story behind the miraculous preservation of these scrolls. Both of these gifts will serve as inspirational reminders that God watches over His inspired word to and for us. Finally, as an ongoing expression of our thanks for choosing to help so many in need, you'll also receive our illuminating and inspiring magazine, Jewish Voice Today. Please remember, God has promised to bless those who bless the Jewish people. To share an urgently needed gift in support of this vital outreach and request your thank you resources, please call, click, or write now. And remember, your generous gift will make you a part of extending life-saving medical help to some very needy Jewish people. Please act now.
I want to show you a tribe now in Zimbabwe that has actually retained Old Testament traditions and rituals for over 2,500 years. They're called the Lemba. We recently held a wonderful outreach to provide medical care, dental care, eye care, even eye surgeries, literally in the bush of Africa. And it was people like you that helped us to make a difference in their lives. Take a look.
In one of the most remote areas of southern Zimbabwe, a team of 51 volunteers were joined by 120 national workers, and together they just finished one of the most challenging and rewarding Jewish Voice outreaches to date. In a week full of both work and ministry, the Lord's hand was clearly seen as Jewish Voice conducted its very first medical outreach to the impoverished Lemba Jewish community.
We've seen children who couldn't speak, they couldn't hear, they couldn't do anything. I'm shocked. And then they can speak, and they can hear, and they can say their names. Babies that there was this 18-month-old baby that couldn't even stand up or sit up, nothing. And then it had witchcraft bracelets on its wrist. They were cut off, and the baby sat up immediately. I mean, eyes to see with adults. I've seen so many miracles. My heart is just filling up. I'm forever going to be changed over this entire experience. It's the best thing that has ever happened to me.
The Lord is looking down on this with favor, and He's looking down on this that He loves culture and He loves diversity. And I had such a warm, wonderful feeling that the Lemba here are very gentle and loving people, and that the Lord has not forgotten them, and that they have retained as much as they possibly can of their culture and of their Jewishness.
You know, you can see the video, but it's so different when you're actually there experiencing these people. This is God's time to help these people, and He wants to use you. So I want you to pray about joining us on one of our outreaches. It's a one-week commitment, and it will change your life, and God will use you to change the life of many, many people in need. We would love to have you join us on one of our next medical outreaches. For more information or to volunteer, you can call 1-800-299-9374. 800-299-9374. You can go to www.pleaseanswerthecall.org. Again, that's pleaseanswerthecall, one word, phonetic.org or call us at 800-299-9374.
The Spirit moving mightily, miracles, fulfilled prophecy, marveling as Jesus calls his people back to himself in preparation for his return, serving as his hands and feet in far-flung places around the globe. I was hungry, and you gave me something to eat. I was thirsty, and you gave me something to drink. I was a stranger, and you invited me in. I needed clothes, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you looked after me. I was in prison, and you came to visit me. The king will reply, I tell you the truth. Whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you did for me. This is what outreach is about with Jewish Voice. You can be a part of it. Now is the time. Answer the call. To find out how, call 1-800-299-YESHUA or go to www.pleaseanswerthecall.org.
Since 1967, Jewish Voice has been dedicated to proclaiming the good news that Yeshua, Jesus, is Messiah and Savior to the Jew first and also to the nations. Now, one way that we do this is by helping some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. We demonstrate God's love by providing medical care, dental care, eye care, even eye surgeries, all free of charge. But most importantly, we share the gospel. And it's through your faithful support that we have the ability to make a difference in their lives. Right now, we need your help. I'm going to ask you to be a part of saving lives, of transforming lives, and blessing desperate Jewish people by sharing a generous gift today. Will you do that? If your answer is yes, we have some very special ways of saying thank you today. I've selected some what I think are very helpful and encouraging resources that I'd like to send you. You can call, you can click, or right now to request them. And remember, your gift of support today will be used to help some of the most impoverished and needy Jewish people in the world. So anything that you can do is going to make a difference in their lives. Hey, by the way, we're on Facebook. You can check us out by going to facebook.com/Jewish Voice and just like us. Well, as I leave you today, I want to remind you, and I do this in every program, I want to remind you to pray for the peace of Jerusalem. The Bible says they shall prosper that love thee. And Israel needs your friendship and prayers today more than ever before. Until next week, this is Jonathan Bernis saying shalom and God bless you.
Jewish Voice is made possible by the support of friends and partners like you.